Hi, and welcome to this Phantasm tutorial. I'm Sebastian Bleek, and in this episode I'll be taking you through how to easily create a duotone effect in Illustrator. If you're not familiar with duotones, think of them as changing your artwork to grayscale, then applying a color tint. Sepia is probably the most common use of this technique. Overall, we'll cover creating a basic duotone, choosing a color tone, and using multiple colors. So let's create a basic duotone. The first thing you want to do is select your artwork. Now that I have my artwork targeted, I can apply this adjustment as a permanent change by going into the Object menu, Filters, Phantasm, and Duotone. If you apply this as a filter, it will be a permanent change. I'm going to hit Escape. For this tutorial, I'd actually like to apply this as a live effect by going into the Effect menu, Phantasm, and then Duotone. When you apply this as a live effect, you're going to have access to edit this in the future. I'm going to click on Duotone. That's going to bring up the Duotone settings for us, and it's applying the basic default Duotone for us. All right, along with this orange color that we've already applied, we have a couple different settings here. Notice over here, just to the left of the color chip, under Active, we have this button here. If you click on it, now it's hollow, and notice we've deactivated this orange color chip. To activate it again, just click on it one more time. Now that it's filled in, it's activating that color for you. All right, over here at the top of the artwork, I have some live text. Just to the right of the color chip, we have this text option here. I could turn the text off and bring it back by clicking on it one more time, and now we've activated the live text again. Now, it's important to note that this feature is only going to work with live text. This feature does not work with outline text. Phantasm is going to look at outline text as just regular anchor points and paths. Now let's take a look at choosing a color tone. To choose a color tone, all you have to do is click right here on this color chip. And that's going to bring up the color picker for you. Now if yours looks a little bit different than mine, just click on this H right here. That stands for hue. If you have it set to any of these other settings, notice the bar and the cube are going to look a lot different. I'm going to go back up to hue, switch this guy to blue, and then just choose any version of this blue that I want. Now that I have the color that I want, I'm going to click OK, and notice it's going to change it over to that blue. Now let's take a look at using multiple colors. To add additional colors, it's really easy. Right over here under color tone, we have these empty color chips for you. Click on the next available one, and that's going to bring up the color picker for you. I'm going to go with the light tone, and click OK to apply that color. Now, not only do we have that blue, but now we have this light orange applied to the artwork. Now, I can adjust these colors individually by using the curves over here at the top. This curve works in the same way as the duotone you'll find in Photoshop. If you're not familiar with this, then watch the detailed video on this topic. Now, the way this guy works is if I want to affect the blue color, I have to come over here towards the center of the settings and make sure I have that blue chip highlighted. Now we have access to that blue curve. I'm going to click on the center and drag it downwards to remove some of that blue. When I release, notice now we have less of that blue. All right, I want to make a change to this orange curve. Back over here in the middle of the settings, I'm going to highlight that color chip. Then I could come back into the curve, click and drag upwards to introduce some more of that orange. All right, now that I've finished making all the edits, I'm going to click OK to apply this live effect. Notice over here in the Appearance panel, if I were to click on this link, I'd be able to edit that live effect again. I'm going to deselect my artwork so you can get a good look at it. And that's it for this tutorial. Overall, we've covered creating a basic duotone, choosing a color tone, and using multiple colors. Make sure you watch the next episode in order to understand how to easily replace color in Illustrator. And don't forget, all of our plugins are available for a free trial at astutegraphics.com. Thanks for watching.